to add another inch to the 17, making it 18 inches. Half of 18 is 9, so I will make the back area 9 inches, 18 inches in total. So that would be the back chest area. And obviously, again, similar measurements to the waist. I'm slightly going to narrow it out on the waist area. Take the shoulder measurements, which are 15 inches, so 8 inches for the shoulder, because half of that is going to be, and that basically is going to be my top back of the dress. Having cut that, I'm going to then go on to cutting the front. Now the front area is going to be 25, and half of 25 is 12 and a half, which is just about coming out to the exact measurement of this particular garment. Now what I will need to do is obviously allow for the bust to be, you know, almost like a gathered effect, where the bust area is going to be almost wider. I've got to create like a cup type of effect to make sure that there is more room on the bust area, and then it's narrowed down again on the waist. So I'm going to take a slight bit away from the waist part, and this is where I will be fitting the belt. Once I have narrowed this down to incorporate the waist area, but the bust area I'm going to have to leave it fairly wide. So again, measure for the shoulder markings, just slight markings for the neckline, and then slope down on the shoulder. The armhole, we are making this, we could use the template for the original one. The length of this, we're going to be doing 7 inches. Now we've got to allow a fair bit of excess here on the front to incorporate for this is the area which is going to be the largest on the bust area. So we've still got to take the circle. We're not going to, otherwise it's going to bulge around the arms. So we've got to take away all the excess away from the sleeve area, leaving a quite a heavy, round, scooped space to incorporate. I mean, she's not very big on the arms and so on. She's got a 36 inch waist, but a 42 inch bust line. So what we've got to do is incorporate that quite a heavy big difference in this in order to in order to accommodate. So this I'm going to pleat in, and then I will attach the bodice back. I will be doing the neckline here and leaving a larger space on this particular area to incorporate for the bust. So if I show you the difference between the front and the back, obviously there is a quite a lot of difference, 2 inches on either side. We've left the front 4 inches larger than the back area. And that's how I would go around and incorporate the bust allowance for a heavier person who is top heavy. Now this is... This was the sleeve, and what I'm going to do is be able to take away the fabric that's been attached on the sleeve, because this is what has been used on the neckline, and we will also be using this on the neckline. One of the things that I'm going to do is use the fabric which is for the dress, for the bodice, to actually do the trims on the sleeves. Now these suits come as supplied with the trims, so you will not need to work or buy extra trims for these. And that's my piece of scalping off, and I have got to cut the two sleeves from this. Now the sleeves are fairly tight fitting sleeves. The only thing I've got to remember in this sleeve is that I have got to incorporate extra space and allowance to fit in with the front cutting of the dress. So the length of these sleeves were 22 inches. I'm going to take the initial cutting and then from this cutting I'm going to open this up, and I will take away the excess from the back, because I cut these both the same, and if you remember there is a 4-inch deeper cut at the front of my dress than there is at the back. So in order to fit that in, fit around the curve of the front of the dress, I need to take away quite a bit from the back of the dress. We also want these sleeves to be fairly tight around the arm circumference. So if I just show you quickly how this would work in relation to the actual dress. This is the back of the dress, and if we measure along the armhole, this will actually end up around about here. I measure this towards the front of the sleeve, it actually measures absolutely to a T, and basically that it would be the difference between the front and the back of my sleeves. What I will do is just slightly narrow this down from the front as well, because we don't want overly bulging on the fabric. And I will attach a small piece of the fabric from the bodice on top of the lining, and hopefully that should be fine. And now it's going to back to trying to assemble all the pieces and seeing what results we get.